Well, long last fall, I was getting ready to go down the county seat to 10 court. Nothing would do Jim Lawson, but he must go along. Jim said maybe he could get a job being a witness, seeing how I was on the jury. Well, we got down there, and I said, Jim, where are we going to stop? I ain't been down at the county seat in so long, I don't know none of the taverns. And Jim said, well, I've got a friend over here who's got a tavern. His name is Buck. Let's go over to the Bug House and stop. Gosh, Jim was just crazy to get into the Bug House. Well, we went over there, and he introduced me to Mr. Bug and Lady Bug and all of the little bugs, and they took us upstairs and showed us into a room, and Jim got to looking around. He said, that's a pretty good bed, Bug. Well, then we went down to supper, and Jim got to eating. He said, I'm a little hungry. You can give me another potato, Bug. And I said, I'm a little thirsty. You can give me a glass of water, Bug. Well, after supper, Bug was out in the backyard chopping up kindling for the next morning. And up come a thunderstorm, and Jim went out and says, I guess you better come in the house or you'll get struck by lightning, Bug. Well, he took a tumble, Buck did, and come into the house, and we were sitting around talking. Jim says, I guess this is the worst thunderstorm we had since last June, Bug. Well, we all got ready, went upstairs to bed, and I heard a noise out in the hall, and I looked out, and by gosh, there was a hired gal kissing Bug. Well, I just come to the conclusion that he was a pretty fly old Bug. And the next morning, I went over to the courthouse, and they wouldn't let me serve on the jury. They said they heard I just got out of the Bug House, and I went back to get Jim, and I met the constable. He said Jim had been drinking a lot of bug juice, cutting up and acting out and carrying on, and he said, for God's sake, keep him in the Bug House.